The Democratic presidential candidates faced off in a debate hosted by CNN and the New York Times last week and took the opportunity to, once again, showcase their abortion extremism. At the Democratic debate in Westerville, Ohio, the candidates reiterated their extreme positions on abortion.
I would codify Roe v. Wade.
And I will create the Office of Reproductive Freedom and Reproductive Rights in the White House.
Our Department of Justice will review that law to determine if it is compliant with Roe v. Wade and the Constitution. And if it is not, that law will not go into effect. That's called preclearance.
One candidate, Hawaii Representative Tulsi Gabbard, did express willingness to restrict abortion in the third trimester.
I support codifying Roe v. Wade while making sure that during the third trimester, abortion is not an option unless the life or severe health consequences of a woman are at risk.
Joining us now in studio is Ramesh Ponnuru, senior editor at National Review, and Marilyn Musgrave, a former U.S. representative from Colorado and the vice president of government affairs for the Susan B. Anthony List. Thank you both for being here.
You're welcome.
Now, welcome.
Marilyn, some of the Democrat candidates said that they would like to codify Roe v. Wade. Is that a sign that they might think the Supreme Court decision could be overturned?
Yes, they're very worried. Many Americans feel the same way. You know, the court has changed. The court has actually agreed to hear a case concerning abortion, Louisiana's admitting privileges law. And, you know, these are times where all eyes are on what's happening in this nation with abortion. States are very enthusiastic about passing pro-life laws. Just in the last year, we've had just under 60 pro-life laws enacted. So it's a time where pro-life people and pro-abortion people are watching this very carefully.
And Ramesh, we heard some really, really extreme proposals from Senators Cory Booker and Kamala Harris about creating a White House office dedicated to safeguarding abortion or using the Justice Department to block pro-life legislation at the state level. Is there any chance of this becoming a reality?
Well, I think a lot of this has to be analyzed in terms of a Democratic primary contest that has mostly been about who can out-abortion the other and who can become more extreme on that issue. Probably the nadir of that contest was reached when Julian Castro said that he wanted to make sure that female-to-male transgender individuals could get abortions. There seems to be a fear on the part of a lot of these candidates that somewhere there's an abortion that's going undone, and this is part of that. I don't think that this is a serious proposal. The Supreme Court has not looked very favorably on this degree of federal intervention into states. It's done it really only in the case of the civil rights laws, and even then with some trepidation. I don't believe the court, as presently constituted, would allow this.
But Marilyn, during the debates, many of the candidates didn't even use the term abortion. They were talking about protecting Roe or reproductive rights. Do you think that that was intentional?
It is intentional. I really believe they want to hide their extremism. They want to put all this in a softer light, so to speak. But note that they're using Planned Parenthood's language, the abortion industry's language, to propose all of this stuff. So they're in lockstep with Planned Parenthood, the abortion industry, for their true agenda, which is abortion on demand up to the moment of birth. That's what they're all about.
Well, and then Representative Tulsi Gabbard decided to differentiate from the rest of the Democrat candidates. She said that she actually wanted to see restrictions on abortion in the third trimester. Ramesh, do you think that that helped her or hurt her?
Well, I think it would be good for the Democratic candidates if their eventual nominee took that position. It's overwhelmingly a popular position. Very few Americans believe that abortion should be legal and unrestricted in the third trimester. Whether it's going to help her in the Democratic primaries is a different question, because the abortion lobby has such a stranglehold on that party, and that's why none of the other candidates are willing to risk its wrath.
And Marilyn, former Planned Parenthood President Lena Wen actually took some time to go on Twitter and weigh in on the debate, writing that she appreciates that Gabbard, quote, brought up the third rail for Democrats, that abortion should be, quote, safe, legal, and rare. We should reduce the need for abortions by investing in prevention. What do you make of Wynn's praise of Gabbard?
Well, it's kind of amazing. It is a third rail, and for people that don't know what that means, there may be some, that is a topic that politicians do not touch because it is so controversial. And when you look at the extremism of the Democratic candidates up there on the stage, they are wildly out of touch with the American people, with their views, as you stated so eloquently. And so, you know, you don't talk about it in that way. But it's interesting that Dr. Wynn, you know, was the head of the largest abortion provider in this country that takes the lives of unborn children, over 325,000 lives a year. So when you look at where she was, head of Planned Parenthood, and when you look at Tulsi Gabbard, you can look at her voting record. She would not even support banning late-term abortion. She voted against the Unborn Child Pain Capable Act. She did not sign the discharge petition demanding that Speaker Pelosi give a vote on the Unborn or the Born Alive Protection Act. So her record speaks very differently. You can't say you want to codify Roe and you want to end late-term abortion or put restrictions on it in the latter part of the pregnancy. Those things do not work together. We are one of seven nations after Roe that allows abortion this late in the pregnancy, and we're not in good company.
And Ramesh, in another tweet, when praised Tulsi Gabbard for using, quote, nuance to talk about abortion, but in today's political climate, is there any room to talk about nuance when it comes to abortion?
Planned Parenthood is the largest provider of abortions in our country, and it is really breathtaking that today's Democratic Party is too extreme even for the former head of Planned Parenthood on this issue. The party used to say that abortion should be safe, legal, and rare, and that was a kind of lip service paid to those Americans who have serious concerns, qualms, or objections to abortion. Now it doesn't even do that. Safe, legal, and rare is no longer in the Democratic platform. That tells you everything about where today's party is.
Ramesh Ponnuru, senior editor at National Review, and Marilyn Musgrave, vice president of government affairs for the Susan B. Anthony List, thank you both for joining me today.
You're very welcome.